Next honored guest, let's welcome Mr. Huichao Zhao. He is the Vice President of the New Energy Vehicle Department Institute from the First Auto Works. He is also the director in charge of the electric drive and the transmission of First Auto Work. Today he will introduce the domestic hybrid transmission technology analysis and future challenge. Welcome.
Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I have a long time not to speak by English, so, but to respect for the organizer, I will try to give my speech by English. Please forgive me the unskilled pronunciation. Okay. Good afternoon. It's my pleasure to have this opportunity to share our investigation and our opinion with all of you, you experts and skillful leading engineers. This report is mainly about the analysis for hybrid transmission technology, the application in Chinese market, and prospect for the technology trend for two-motor architecture. In terms of the policy, reviewing the introduced request in recent years, the government have very strong determination to promote vehicles' energy save and emission reduction, and will continuously to push the improvement of technical. For the past 5 years, HEV has got very good chance to gain rapid improvement parallel to the EV, and seems have even more power to increase on the market according to the higher cost performance ratio and the ease of use. If we only focus on the HEV, not including the PHEV, we can see the market almost totally occupied by two-motor architecture, especially from the Toyota and the Honda, which have all hybrid functions and developed from system level, balance the requirement for all of the downstream components. And talk about the PHEV. For our opinion, actually HEV have real difference from PHEV. Both one motor architecture and two motor architecture can be qualified for the requirement. But one motor architecture has the advantage for past years because it can be carried over from the traditional powertrain and easy to put into production, put into the market. But now, two-motor architecture also increased very fast and have big chance to exceed. For the one-motor architecture, P2 and P2.5 now almost cover all of the one motor architecture, and two motor architecture seems have more flexibility. And on the global market, HEV has share bigger part and have more application on compact and fuel efficiency sensitive vehicles. PHEV have the advantage for higher output ability, so have better use on large performance sensitivity vehicles. Reviewing the history of hybrid technology in domestic market, many solutions had been adapted. Different requirements need different architecture and different structure to support. One motor architecture normally has parallel traction. Motor power and engine power can be added together, so can gain more power output. But the contribute from the fuel consumption side by changing engine working conditions seems a little bit limited. Two motor architecture can achieve better engine working conditions and also give more flexibility for the engine development to get better fuel consumption on specific position. The traction power more depends on the motor and the battery, which means more depends on the money. So normally, the two motor architecture not defined too high performance. This is a typical one motor hybrid system. The biggest advantage is can be platformization with traditional transmission. So it may be the best solution for companies who have already big amount of investment on traditional transmission to transit the products from traditional to dedicated hybrid transmission. This kind of architecture will be helped much. Currently, the P2 is nearly the best choice according to the purpose of carryover part. But sometimes the package is limited. So sometimes we choose P2.5. For fuel saving or to meet the pollution requirement request, only by P2 or by P2.5 is not enough. So normally, we add battery, and we choose PHEV. For two motor architecture, there are several typical structure. Toyota's power split is the most matured and succeeded, and still continuously upgraded for more powerful and more fuel economy. The whole system, including engine, e-motor system, transmission, battery, and also thermal and energy management systems, etc., are all improved together. The requirement of dynamic performance or the power output strongly influence the cost, so need to be balanced precisely. So Toyota choose some methods, including improve the engine volume to get more power, raise the motor speed, and use higher voltage to minimize the e-motor and also to save material cost. And the other typical structure is the series parallel hybrid system represented by the Mitsubishi and Honda Accord. In recent years, thanks for the simple structure and better expandability, this kind of products growing very fast. Last two speakers from BYD and Changcheng have also show their success by this architecture. It can also give us enough flexibility to get the solution for different requirements. So two-motor architecture is an flexible architecture. So we can match the target to save cost, save the components cost, or to gain the very good fuel consumption. And actually, if we give some innovation for the structure, we can also get high performance. In Chinese market, there are plenty of material resources or components which can support this architecture. And so the cost of components can be relatively easier to save. This is two-motor series hybrid system. Similar with the series parallel structure, only to release the clutch, we can get the function. And we can do some work to simplify the structure, make it smaller, and make it weight lighter. The engine can only work at several points, not for whole working condition. So we can get very cheap solutions. But because of the power and the energy consumption are difficult to be the best, it only used for small car or range extender on the current market. From this analysis, the development of hybrid technical is constrained by driving conditions, supplier resources, fuel saving requirements, power demand, and the total cost of life cost, etc. Different country, different brand, and different application need the vehicles to set different development requirements, which lead the coexistence of multiple technology solutions for a long time. At present, in Chinese market, the two-motor system may have more opportunities to grow faster. This last chapter mainly focuses on domestic two-motor architecture technology prospect. First, the technology roadmap for energy saving and the new energy vehicle 2.0 schedule the passenger car's main parameters for the next 15 years and put forward clear objects for electric transformation. Therefore, from the perspective of trend, the traditional powertrain will gradually decrease. HEV will occupy a large market proportion instead of the traditional vehicles. And from the trend side, a real hybrid must be the best balance of dynamic energy saving and cost according to the demand of adaptive objects. There we also have a very important variable by the very fast technical improvement and the cost reduction of e-motor and the battery. We can drive more by the motor and give more space for engine to raise its fuel economy. For the two-motor structure, it will have following main characteristics. First, an ultra-high thermal efficiency engine. Second, an electric drive system that combines power and economy under full working conditions. And the third, a power energy balanced battery, which can be best meet the vehicle dynamic performance. The last point, and also very important, we can get the benefit from the digitalization to forecast the driving conditions and to schedule the energy consumption, and also to define how much batteries are needed. We know the real power needed for highway or driving cycle are very low. In real driving conditions, most of the energy lost by transient working conditions. The motor are more good at transient work than engine. So keep the engine stable, use the motor to transient work, can get more benefit. For hybrid vehicle, the energy comes only from the engine. So how to improve the engine conversion efficiency is the key point. If we give engine a relative stable working condition and not need much power to drive, we have many chance to push the combustion efficiency to be more than 50%. The battery is still cost effective and resource effective, but the technology getting improved very fast. The company who can control the battery can get more benefit, not only on the cost, but also on the whole system definition. E-motor will be the main driving components on the vehicle in the future, which needs to have characteristic of high performance, efficiency, lower noise, and light weight. E-motor evolution is driven by the basic materials, manufacturing, and the developing tools, including some the simulation and auto testing. E-motor controllers or the inverter is the core component to realize high performance, efficiency, safety, and the electromagnetic comparability of electric drive system. Power device technology evolution, control platform technology upgraded, and control strategy optimized are the main paths which support for the advancement of e-motor controller technology. This picture shows us from the function side, the technical evolution of the special hybrid transmission or the dedicated hybrid transmission is no longer the traditional speed change device, but it changes to the electromechanical coupling device. It also has many possibilities for the improvement. The constantly requirements are high efficiency, comfort, NVH, reliability, and durability. In addition, the requirements affecting comfort and competitiveness are disconnect, non-working power source, power shaft, thermal management on demand. From our investigation, now domestic dual motor hybrid application can meet most of the requirement for different types of vehicles. Based by excellent fuel saving functions, power can be variable by adding gears or adding additional e-motor system. In the future, the series structure may extend the scope of use according to the intelligent driving. That's all of my sharing. Thank you very much. Thank you.
thanks, Mr. Zhao, and your presentation. Any question?
赵总，我想请问一下，就是咱们红旗和奔腾两个品牌的话，在混动的这种方案考虑上是怎么规划的？就是具体的应用。红旗现在在混动上，我们基本上也是在遵循双电机这个路线，但是我们和国内的其他公司相比呢，我们选择的是
HEV 的路线。这个 HEV 路线呢？ 因为我们一汽自己并没有电池，所以我们还是在尽量的依靠我们自己的发动机的能力，尽量去节省电池，所以我们也发现，在 HEV 的开发过程中，实际上跟 PHEV 还是有一定的区别的，可能要稍微难一点。这个奔腾呢，它总体来说在混合动力这个层面呢，它自主权会更大一点。红旗的这个方案选择呢，也是奔腾的这个。 它的选择之一，但它可以，就是有权利，也有条件去选择更适合它这个车型定位的这个混合动力技术线，它也做了很多尝试。然后那个，其实一个企业并不一定要遵循一条技术线，实际上我们在单电机的路线上也有开发。
这个里头的典型代表就是长城，长城是基本上所有的构型都有，其实我刚才想问问题，这个我看这个不太礼貌，我就没问，但是这说明我们还是从技术线上还是有很多可选择的，但是看你自己的车型怎么定位，不同企业有不同的想法，好。那个赵院，我就向你咨询一下，不好意思，我看你讲的那个未来的混动技术一些 evolution 进化。 你这边我如果没记错的话，提了两点。你点是那个电机的 evolution， 一个就是所谓的电机控制器的 evolution。 是从您观点讲，今后的所谓的双电机的里面，会慢慢的会忽视机械结构的 evolution 差异化，而着重侧重点在电机和电控这个系统里面的 evolution。
我大概知道你这个意思，我尝试从两个方面跟说一下。 首先就是从电机和电控的技术升级的角度呢，其实它还有很大的潜力可挖。比如说我们在传动业务、传动领域，如果是不是电机领域的话，我们经常会想到，我靠传动的速比变化去适应电机的这个经济区，然后去弥补它的这个动力性。这是跟我们原来的就是变速箱匹配发动机的这个 思路呢是一脉相承的，所以大家是有一定的惯性。电机的这个效率区呢，包括它的一些功率的变化，实际上是相对要灵活一点。比如说我，就比如说最简单的，我把这个电机控制器的电流调整，那个电流的调整实际上是比较简单。我可以将来做这个功率模块的时候，我可以通过并联，我可以实现300安、400安、500安、600安。然后我电流不同意的时候，相当于发动机排量就变了。 因为我输出电流能力，我电压在，是吧？电压是一定的，电流能力增强了，那么它的功率指标就增加了。所以呢，它在电机本体的这种这个变化上，会相对有更多灵活度。所以呢，在这个传动领域呢，实际上是要跟这个电机的领域相配合，就是电机它能做什么样的变动和 传动能做什么样的变动，要统合到一起去寻找一个最佳的性价比的一个方案，而不是，当然了，现在咱们的一些尝试呢都非常有意义的，这个是我个人观点。第二个呢，就是说，那这样的话，传动是不是就没有它的可发挥的余地了呢？这个是从这个角度呢，不是的，这个就是不论如何，电机不可能去 做到去直接驱动车轮，至少在目前这个状态下，因为它去直接驱动车轮的话，会给它带来巨大的成本的增加，包括重量安全性等等。那么它必然需要中间一个传动的一个转换的装置。那么我们在不同的整车的需求的时候，我们可能会需要更多的档位，虽然我们就是假如说我们
定义一个车型要求不是很高，就是一个经济型车的话，那我们可能单电机单挡就足够了，我靠电机自身的微调去实现它的这个效率区域的偏移啊。但是呢，我在一些高性能车、豪华车上，可能这个就不见得合适了，因为电机你要全靠电机驱动，不仅仅是电机的成本增加，电池的成本也一样会增加，所以最后还是看一个最佳性价比的这么一个概念。不知道我这个回答够不够？
哎，姐，你这个真知灼见，感谢。
啊。